open up.
The dragon's spirit floods your mind and memory in a great torrent of power. He is with you. He is within you. He is you. The next words that spill from your...
I am Ansa, heart of the gate, butchered in flesh.
Ansa, the spirit...
Answer me, Facey. Why have you come?
A deep
wrack.
The Emperor's stone.
Bold you. Your pre.
Answer me. We knew it would answer.
Friend. Until have you. That you. And now you bring your thrall.
Stillman.
Dear.
End. I gate. Let my bow. I am not this time.
Nightmare. must these mortals be?
My true identity is the one you've known from the moment we met. I conceal nothing from you. I simply left out the details that were not pertinent to our cause. But it seems you are interested in them. I killed Ansor out of necessity. For the crime of being an illithid, he would have killed me first. It's like I always told you. I was just like you. An adventurer who yearned for greatness. And in mortal terms, I achieved it. As captain of the Wandering Eye, I acquired enough gold to found Baldur's Gate. I stayed for a while to watch my city grow. But it was not enough. I grew restless again. The sea called to me, and I ran to her with open arms. Life at sea was not easy. Our last adventure was ruinous. My ship was destroyed, my crew lost, but my spirit was far from broken. I was determined to return in triumph once again. I heard of treasure in Moonrise. I strove to find it. What I found was an illithid colony, where I acquired a tadpole much like yours, and became a mind flayer, enthralled to the Elder Brain. It was Ansor who found me. Ansor who brought me home. He sought to cure me of my sickness, called on every healer he could find, nearly broke his spirit in the attempt. But he failed to understand. I wanted no healing. I was not sick. Even after he had exhausted all possibility of reversing my condition, he still clung to hope. I tried to convince him of my reality. I was on the cusp of greatness beyond my wildest dreams. But all he could see was a mind flayer. He came to me as I slept. A mercy killing in his mind. I saw the tears. I felt his grief. I had no choice but to kill him first. It was an act of self-preservation. Place, you would have done the same. Do not think that I am ignorant of what I have lost. I may not regret my actions, but I do regret that they were necessary. While the past is beyond my influence, the present is not. It is time we move on.
Never a dull moment.